Hello my dear students, welcome to my next online class. So in place of this interactive class, I have taken this online video mode to teach you today. So in my interactive class, many were facing this network problem. They are poor, due to poor network, they are not able to view the board. Okay, so I thought to make one video on the numericals, that is AC circuit numericals, right? We will solve few questions from AC circuit numericals. And these questions which I will be solving here, you need to write in your exercise book. Also prepare the similar type of questions in your home, right? So without any delay, let's start our class today. In a LCR circuit with all the components connected in series, the EMF and current flowing in the circuit are given by the following equation. That means in LCR circuit, LCR, that is inductor, capacitor and resistor, when LCR circuit is connected with an alternating voltage here, this is an inductor, this is a capacitor and this is one resistor. This is being connected with an alternating voltage here, positive, negative, LCR here, right? So what is the voltage supplied here? That is given by E equals to 200 sine 3140 plus pi by 6 volt. And current is given here 5 sine 314 small t ampere. Now what we have to find here, obtain the peak values of current and EMF. So peak value of current and EMF, now you see, we know alternating voltage, that is given by E equals to E naught sine omega t, and current is given I naught sine omega t, right? E equals to E naught sine omega t and I equals to I naught sine omega t. Now if we compare this equation, equation number 1 with this, okay, equation 1 and equation 2. So, and let us consider or keep it as this one, equation number 2. This one has 3, equation number 1 and equation number 2 from the question itself, okay? So you need to write this question, these equations once more when you are solving. So you will mark this one as equation 1, equation 2, and E equals to E naught sin omega t as equation 2, I equals to I naught sin omega t as equation number 3, right? Now comparing equation 1 and 2, what we will get now, if you compare this equation with this, what we will get, E naught equals to 200. That means in place of E naught, what we have, 200, that means 200 volt. So our peak value of voltage is 200 volt. Similarly, when we will compare, similarly comparing 2 and 3, if you compare 2 and 3, in place of I naught, what we have, 5. That means I naught equals to 5 ampere, right? So E naught is 200 ampere and I naught is 5 ampere. So after getting the first answer, next we will see the frequency of AC source. The frequency of AC source, we know omega equals to 2 pi f. That means angular frequency equals to 2 pi f into linear frequency. So we need to find here f, that means omega by 2 pi. Now what is the value of omega? You see directly it is given. Now if you compare with this equation, that is equation number 1 and equation number 2, in place of omega, what we have here? 314t. And that means along with t we have omega, along with t we have 314. So therefore in place of omega we will be writing 314. And pi value we will take 3.14, right? So 3.14, that means 314, if you take the points up, then 100 will be up. 2 into 314 gets cancelled. That is 100 by 2, that is 50 hertz. Okay, that means 50 hertz is the frequency. Next, what we have to find, so we have found the peak values of current and EMF. Peak value of current is 5 ampere, peak value of EMF is 200 volt. The frequency of AC source is how much? 50 hertz. Next, what we have to find, the phase difference between current and EMF. So you see, current is this one, 5 sine 3140, 200 sine 3140 plus pi by 6. So what is the phase difference between current and voltage? That means phase difference is last answer, that is answer number 3. Phase difference, or just directly you can say that phase difference equals to pi by 6, that means plus pi by 6. Now you see which is leading here, voltage is leading and current is lagging. So voltage is leading current by angle of pi by 6. So next question, we have an alternating EMF of 100 volt RMS. 50 hertz is applied across a capacitor of 10 microfarad and a resistor of 100 ohm. Calculate the reactance of the capacitor. Now you see, when it is said reactance of the capacitor, that means they are asking XC. Right, XC we have to find. And what else given in the question? The alternating EMF, that means VRMS or ERMS is given 100 volt. Okay, 50 hertz, that means frequency is given here 50 hertz. And capacitor is given 10 microfarad. And resistor is given 100 volt. We have to find the reactance of the capacitor and we have to find the current, right? And we have to find the average power. So these are the things which is given, and this XC, I and average power we have to find. So in order to find XC, first we will find XC here, that means capacitive reactance. This is given by 1 by omega C formula, right? Now omega can be written as, again, 1 by omega can be written as 2 pi F C. So omega means 2 pi F and C as it is. Now 2 pi means 3.14 into frequency. How much is the frequency given in the question? That is 50 hertz. I'll substitute with 50 here. Now C is given here 10 microfarad. Now 10 micro can be written 10 to the power minus 6 farad. Okay, so farad is the unit of capacitor. So 10 to the power minus 6 farad. Now we need to solve this one. So first, what we will do here, you see, 10 to the power minus 6 and 10, this will go up. That means minus 6 will become 10 to the power 6, and in the denominator we will be left out with 50 into 10, that is 500. Now we will just multiply this one. So you see, 500 into 2 into 3.14. So when we multiply this one, so this 3, when you multiply, what we get here? 3140, right? Now 3140, 6 zeros divided by 3140, when you divide this one, we will be getting here 318.47, right? So it will be ohm. So directly when you divide, you will be getting 318.47 ohm. So XC is an opposition to the flow of current, so therefore its unit is ohm. Now after getting XC, what we have to find here? Current. Now we know V equals to IR. Now it is not an R, now it is ZC, and here it is V. So ZC equals to, or first we have to find here impedance, that is capacitive impedance. So ZC can be written as root under R square plus XC square. Again, we will substitute here, in place of R, we will substitute here 100 square plus XC square, that is 318.47 square. Okay, so after getting its square, so after calculation, we will be getting here, you see, ZC R square plus XC square, I have substituted. After solving this one, we got here 333 ohm, that means impedance we got 333 ohm. Now current means here voltage by impedance, so voltage is given in the question, that is 100. So 100 by 333 will be getting, I have divided here and got 0.3 ampere, right? So now we have got this reactance also, we have got current flowing. Now average power supply, the last portion here, average power supply. So average power is given by VRMS into IRMS cos phi, right? VRMS into IRMS into cos phi. Cos phi means here power factor. Power factor again can be written as R by Z. So these values we will substitute now. IRMS, how much did you get here? 0.3, that means 3 by 10. VRMS is given in the question, that is 100. So 100 into 3 by 10 into R. R is also given in the question, that is 100. And here Z we got here 333, right? So 10 and 10 got cancelled. Now calculation, that is 3000 by 333. Now when you divide this one, 3000 divided by 333, what will you get here? 9. So we'll be getting here 9. Next question we have, in the circuit drawn, the current is found to lag behind the voltage by an angle of 36.9 degree. So here you see current is lagging behind, that means voltage is leading. So it is an RL circuit. In an RL circuit, current is lagging and voltage is leading by an angle of pi by 2, which we have seen in the phasor diagram. And when I was going through the purely resistive circuit, purely inductor and purely capacitive circuit in that time, right? But in this question here, the phase difference is already mentioned here, that is 36.9 degree. What we have to calculate? Inductive reactance. Inductive reactance means we have to calculate XL here from here first. After getting the XL, impedance of the circuit, right? And the frequency of the applied EMF. So these three things we have to find, and the given in the question is that inductor of inductance 0.1 Henry. So Henry's is the unit of inductor. Cos 36.9 degree is 4 by 5, tan 36.9 is 3 by 4. So these values we have to take, right? So you see, most probably this will be tan inverse, right? So tan inverse or tan, I think there is a misprint in the question. Just we will solve and we will see that what is the misprint here, okay? So let it keep like this only. So I have copied this directly, same question here. Now you see, inductive reactance we have to calculate. We know phase difference. Phase difference, that is tan phi, is given by XL by R, this formula, right? So tan phi equals to XL by R is given. So you see, what is the phi given here? That means, no, it won't be tan inverse, it is tan only. So tan in place of phi will be substituting here. Excuse me. So 36.9 equals to, in place of XL, what we will substitute here, we need to find here XL divided by R. So R is given in the question, that is 40, right? Now tan 36.9, this value is given 3 by 4. That means 3 by 4 equals to XL by 40, or XL equals to 3 by 4 into 40. So 4 tens are, that means 30 ohm. So XL, how much did we get here? XL we got here 30 ohm. Now after getting the XL, we have to find the impedance of the circuit. Impedance is given by ZL equals to root under R square plus XL square. Like in the previous question, we have solved R square plus XC square. So here similar, R square plus XL square. So in place of R, we will be substituting here 40, that is 40 square, because resistance is given 40, and XL we got here 30, that means 30 square. So 1600 plus 900 will give you 2500, and 2500 square root is 50 ohm. So impedance also we got here easily, that is 50 ohm, and inductive reactance also here 30 ohm. Now what we have to find? Frequency of the applied EMF. So frequency, to find the frequency of the applied EMF, we know XL equals to omega L, or XL equals to 2 pi FL. F we have to find, that means XL by 2 pi L, we'll just cross multiply. Now in place of XL, we'll substitute the value of XL, that is 30, and 2 pi, that pi 3.14, in L, that is 0.1, which is given in the question. Now rest we'll solve this one. We have to use a calculator. Now 2 into 3.14 into 0.1, that is 30 by 0.628. Now we will divide 30 divided by 0.628. What we'll get here? That is 47.7. So this is the frequency, that means hertz, right? So this is our required answer. 47.7 hertz, you can also write 48 hertz, okay? You will round off, because 0.7 is more than 5, or you can leave your answer up to here only, 47.7 hertz or 48 hertz, anyone. Next question we have, a sinusoidal voltage V equals to 200 sine 3140 is applied to a resistor of 10 ohm resistance. That means from the question, from first two lines, we can understand that it is a purely resistive circuit, okay, whose alternating voltage is given and whose resistance is given, that is of 10 ohm, right? So this one first we will write here, that is V equals to 200 sine 3140, right? And resistor is given here 10 ohm. What we have to calculate? RMS value of voltage. So V RMS equals to V naught by root 2. This is the formula. What is the V naught here? So V naught we have here, that is 200, that means peak value of voltage, that means 200 volt. Now if you substitute here, that is V RMS, that is 200 by root 2. Now this 200 by root 2, we can rationalize this one by multiplying by root 2 in denominator and root 2 in numerator. So what we'll get here, 200 by root 2 into root 2, that is 2, that means 2 root 2, that is 2 into 100, that means 100 root 2. Okay, and 100 into 1.414, right? So 1.414, you see what we'll get here. So this value, we know the root 2 value is 1.414. Now VRMS, that is 100 into 1414 by 1000. 10, 2 zeros got cancelled, that means 141.4 volt. Okay, VRMS. So this is our one answer. Next we have to find the RMS value of current. IRMS means V equals to VRMS equals to IRMS into R. This is the formula. So IRMS equals to VRMS by R. So VRMS, how much it is? Just now we have calculated, that is 1, or in place of VRMS, just we substitute here, then it will be easy. That means 200 root 2, right? VRMS value is 100 root 2 by R. How much is R here? R we got here 10, that is 10, 0, 0 got cancelled, that means 10 root 2. So 10 into 1.414. So if you multiply that, 14.14 ampere. So IRMS also we got here. Now we need to find the power dissipated as heat. Power dissipated, P equals to VRMS into IRMS into cos phi. This is the formula, that means loss in power. So VRMS, how much we got here? VRMS we will substitute here, that is 100 root 2. IRMS we will substitute here 10 root 2. And cos phi, that means for purely resistive circuit, cos phi equals to 1, because phase difference is 0 degree. They are in the same phase. That means in place of cos phi, what you will write here? 1, right? So root 2 into root 2, what we will get? 2 and 3 zeros, that means 2000 watt. So this is our answer, right? So similar type of questions you try to solve from your book. If you have SL Aurora, solve from there, or any other book, right? Similar type of questions you solve, and you see how to calculate the power dissipation. So the questions which I have solved today, this type of questions has been repeated. So I have seen in the 10 years, like the questions which have come many times is similar these types. We have to find phase difference, we have to find impedance, we have to find the current, power dissipation. Okay, so see you soon in my next online class.